CodyO Show. Today we're going to be working on jack-o'-lanterns because it's September and it's going to take a little bit to fire them, and we've got to be ready for Halloween with our jack-o'-lanterns. So starting off, I've got 6 pounds of clay. In the shape I want it to be. Workable, and it's all the platelets in a spiral shape, which makes it a lot easier to throw. It's kind of weird because I feel like I'm talking to myself, but I'm actually talking to potentially millions of viewers, so I'm a little intimidated at the same time. So anyway, probably good. Go ahead and make the hole. Check how thick that bottom is. So I'll kind of do that as I spread out my bottom. Now I'm going to try to make the base of this thing at its final width right now at this point, as opposed to later deciding, oh hey, I want that a little bit wider or narrower. It's like, kind of got to establish that at this point. Otherwise you'll just get the clay will get tired and just fall down on you. And the bottom here, I'm going to see how thick it is. It's too thick. It's alright, because I'm working across that bottom, back and forth. Potters out there, you'll know about S cracks. Anytime you try to do something flat, the clay tends to dry up and pull away from itself, and you feel an S crack where there's a now I'm going to get ready to start bringing the walls up. I'm actually going to bring them up. I'm just going to kind of stay prepared for it. sure it's even consistency. And then I want to take that rim and just kind of start that, bend it inwards. Because as you're bringing walls up, they always want to spread out like this. So I just kind of, if I want it to go straight, then you kind of got to bring it inwards to start with. Final shape, and I'm gonna kind of do the bottom half of the section.